What's up guys, this is Ian. So first of all, I'd like to welcome all the new subscribers because I think we went up about by 100 since last week's video. So thank you so much for the support. It's a small number but it really means a lot to me. So anyway, I didn't get to film a lot last week because it was the busy week and hell week that I was talking about in my previous videos if you watched it. By the way, this video is especially for the architecture students. If I have any viewers that are architecture students, this is especially for you guys because I am gonna mention all the things that I wished I learned before I stepped onto that thesis stage of architecture school. So yun, anyway, pauwi ako ngayon, but I did get to film my last day of the hell week, which was my mock defense. So I think while I'm on that, I am gonna show you what happened last week. So yun, and uwi muna ako and I'm gonna show you what happened last week while we're at it. So bye bye. Alright, so I have a mock defense for a thesis today and I am so running late. But welcome to today's video and I'm gonna bring you with my thesis journey. Okay, so bye-bye.
Oh, you got history. Got me feeling the nostalgia when you look at me. Thinking about what could have happened or what could have been. Finally,
oh my God, I know it's that I'm supposed to see.
Take my time and take your clothes off one more time, maybe. Acting like you don't recall it ain't impressing me.
Made it. Kasi hindi pa ako tapos sa presentation ko. Shit. Right, so 2:53 and ako na yung susunod sa presentation and fingers crossed maganda yung comments sa makuha ko, but I'm pretty sure na makakuha ko ng negative comments, so yun lang, bye bye.
We got history, got me feeling the nostalgia when you look at me. Thinking about what could have happened or what could have been. Finally your face, I know it, that it's sight to see. Take my time to take your clothes off one more time, maybe. Acting like you don't be caught. Done and new with things, but we got history. Put my feelings all aside, don't know what to make it right. Pictures popping on my mind, all these occasions, let's work it out with me. I don't think it hurts to give another try on it. Ain't nobody here know you like I.
Right, so katapos ko lang mag mock defense and I did get quite a few comments. Some of them are positive, some of them are hindi naman siya negative, but they're constructive, as I would say. Yeah, so I don't know if you can see it, but yes. So as I'm filming this video, hindi ko pa alam actually kung ano yung ito title ko dito, but I do have an idea now. Siguro I am gonna make a video about the things that I wish I knew before I moved on to my thesis year, stuff like that. And uwi muna ako and I am gonna tell you guys more about that in just a bit, but yeah, basically all the things that I wish I knew na before I came into this stage, I will talk about in this video. Because honestly, there are quite a few things that you learn in your first to fourth years of architecture school, but then you tend to forget them. And once you are in your thesis year, because I'm pretty much sa thesis year, like everything that you need to know, you're actually gonna be learning them as you go on with a lot of time pressure. So I am putting this video out here just for you to be aware of the things you should need to study or know just before you move on to your thesis. So that's all I have to say for now, and next part of the video, hindi ko alam kung saan, but I'll see you there.
Hey, what's up guys? So nakabalik na ako ng bahay and I am gonna jump straight right into the things that I wish I did or learned just before I entered this stage in my architecture school life. So without further ado, let's discuss the first thing. So the first thing I wish I did just before I entered my thesis year is I wish I invested more time on the 3D modeling and visualization techniques, because this is probably one of the things that take up your time the most, especially when you are doing it in a lot of time pressure, just watching all the YouTube stuff and downloading all the SketchUp plugins that you need for you to execute your design. Because just learning on how to translate your design ideas from sketches into architecture programming is pretty much very time consuming if you aren't invested in your skills. So really being practiced and having all these knowledge will become a substantial benefit in the future. So you don't have to be stressed just learning all these new things and just be straight up stressed that you can't execute your design properly. So yeah. So anyways, moving on to the second thing I wish I knew is I wish I knew where to find all the sources for my thesis research, because I spent a lot of time just staying in the library finding all these books. But don't get me wrong, mas maganda pa rin if your sources come straight from the book, because that makes your information so much more reliable than just getting it from the internet. But there are a lot of things that you can only find on the internet, and I am gonna put up a list on the sites that you can find all these sources and the research papers. Yeah, so I wish I didn't stress out just trying to find all this information back when I was just starting. So moving on to the third thing, this is more of a tip because I kind of already knew this, is how to organize your files. I mean, from my first to fourth years, I just gotta sinasabog ko lang lahat ng files ko sa desktop, which you are also probably guilty of. But fortunately for me, I did learn how to organize my files properly when I did my apprenticeship back last summer. So thank you to the firm that I worked for, Shanghai Architects, for this knowledge. And I am gonna put up a screenshot on how I do my file organizing for my thesis so that you can use it as a reference for when you start. So moving on to the fourth thing is Microsoft Word organizing. It's so funny because in my fifth year, tsaka ko lang natutunan how to make a proper table of contents and all the headings and subheadings. Dati enter lang ako and just bold out yung subtitles and titles. But I am gonna show you a screen recording of how to do this, just so you don't have to scroll all the way down just to find the information that you are trying to find. This is pretty helpful actually, so huwag nyo kakalimutan to. And the next thing, hindi ko na alam kung ano number ko, is how to make a proper SWOT analysis. SWOT analysis is analysis of strengths, weaknesses, opportunities, and threats. To be honest, up to this day, I still do not know how to do a proper one or a decent one. But big thanks to my professor who taught us how to do a decent one. And I'm gonna show you how to do this. It's basically like a Punnett square where you reference all the information that you've gathered to come up with an analysis. Just your strengths, weaknesses, and your opportunities and threats. Combine them and come up with an analysis. So there you have it. And moving on to my, I guess, second to the last tip is how to make a good narrative and storytelling, as well as finding the right balance between quality and quantity. So what I mean by this is sort of a blanket statement which applies to your all presentations and your research content writing. Because a lot of students think that the higher density that your book has means it has more information, therefore it has a higher quality, which in my opinion isn't true, because you can write a very dense and thick book with a lot of nonsensical and filler information and have your reader take up so much time in absorbing all that information, whereas you can write a very concise, straight to the point, as well as finding the right balance between quality and quantity, which makes your storytelling much better for your reader to fully absorb it in just a good period of time. So, and moving on to my last tip, and you've probably already heard of this, is do choose a thesis topic that you are personally interested in, and do not try to emulate the things that you see or yung thesis ng higher batches just because you think it's trending in architecture school right now. Because you're gonna be doing your thesis for about a year and a half, and you don't want to be researching and gathering all that information, and then midway you just become so uninterested because you're researching something that you are not passionate about. But at the same time, do assess if it's something valuable and something that can contribute to the pool of knowledge of architecture. Also, do consult with your professor a lot, because you may have this very good concept or thesis proposal, but sometimes you just become too idealistic to the point that your research topic becomes unachievable. Do consult a lot with the professionals or consult with your classmates, because you will need a lot of fresh eyes to assess your topic, whether it is really a good one. So, yun lang, that's probably all the things and tips that I am going to be telling you for now. Do let me know, if you're watching this video, comment down below what types of video you want to see me making, because it will really help me out a lot in progressing my YouTube stuff. So yeah, thanks so much for watching, and I am gonna end this video right here. If you like any part of this video, please consider dropping a like or subscribe, and that's it for today's video. I'll see you guys next time.
We got history, got me feeling the nostalgia when you look at me.